Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? I tend to avoid talking about some of the minor meteor showers, like the 80 Aquarids and some other ones, just because they don't really produce a lot of meteors, maybe 15 to 20 per hour, which means at best you would see one every 3 to 4 minutes under ideal conditions, at the peak, under dark skies. So I try to focus on the ones that are really good ones. And even though the Perseids are warm when they occur in August, and the Geminids coming up here in just a couple days, it's colder weather. The Geminids actually produces more meteors per hour than the Perseids does. So it's a really great one to be able to see. Let's talk about why this one is producing so many meteors and why it's actually producing more. And that's partly because it happens to be associated with an asteroid called 3200 Phaethon. You can see its orbit here. It goes well outside that of where Mars is at. It goes well inside the sun and passes close to the sun. And as it comes back around and leaves a lot of that bits of dust and sand and whatever else off of the comet as it gets cracked from getting so close to the sun, it leaves all that in its orbit as it kind of goes through our orbit. And then when we plow through that, we see meteors as they burn up into the atmosphere. Now, this particular object is kind of interesting because, and this was taken by the Arecibo Radio Observatory, which unfortunately just had a catastrophic incident, which means they're going to be closing it down. So we are fortunate we have these. But these are basically different radio images of how this particular asteroid looks. And it's about 5.8 kilometers in diameter. So it's decent sized, but still small for us to be able to see that. However, because it is this asteroid, not really a comet, as it goes close to the sun, it kind of gets heated up. It gets up to perhaps 1,000 degrees or more, and then it cracks and leaves all these objects behind. And so when it orbits, we start to see meteors in the sky. Now, the Geminids are going to appear to radiate from a point not too far away from where the star Castor is in the constellation of Gemini. So you can find that below Capella and to the left of where Orion is. If you're in the northern hemisphere, if you're in the southern hemisphere, you're going to have a different view of that for sure. But for most of us that are watching, we will be able to see it radiate from here. But you don't want to necessarily look right at there. Really what we tend to do is we're going to look outside of there. So if I bring up our angle measuring tool, if you look maybe 30 to 50 or 60 degrees beyond there, out in this area, this is where you're going to probably see more of those meteors is out in this direction. So if we look here like this, we can see that we would be really looking almost up overhead. So just get a comfortable chair. You're going to want to definitely dress warm because you're not really going to be moving a lot. What I find works well is maybe a sleeping bag and a blanket. It might actually help to put a blanket underneath you because that as you compress that insulation under you as you sit, you'll actually be colder from the back than you will be from the front where you have more fluffier layers to keep trap the air above you. So maybe put another layer or two underneath where you are. And then you can just look up. You might want to face towards the east, northeast in general, and start looking ideally at about 10 p.m. or so. But if you do need to look earlier than that, because we'd be going from basically a Sunday into a Monday, that's okay because it's December 13th into the 14th, and the 14th is the Monday, but we want to start looking on the 13th, and then just look up. You don't need any optical aid. You don't need binoculars. You don't need a telescope. If you want to use binoculars, you can to try to look at some of the trails as they may occur, but mostly you're just trying to just see as much of the night sky as you possibly can at once and look for those meteors as they streak across the sky. And the Geminids are quick. They're faster than the Perseids are. They're also maybe not quite as bright just because of the type of debris that 3200 Phaethon leaves. But this is an easy naked eye event that you can enjoy with the entire family. Everyone just bundle up, get outside, get a nice chair where you can lean back and look up at the sky and enjoy as much as you can and try to get away from as many lights as possible too, because that will definitely help the darker the area that you're able to be, or block lights that's going to assist you in seeing more of those Geminids. So that's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.